Der nächste Vortrag geht über Repair Cafés.
The next lecture is about Repair Cafés. Repair your stereo, your soldering iron. I would first try Google, find if YouTube shows me something. But in these days, repair cafes are almost in every city. I think that there are many more things which can be repaired, up to repairing PCBs and reballing ICs. What they all do will be presented by you, by Fraxinas now. You're listening to the translation of this talk held by Pharma Firma and HNMS.
Okay.
I will switch off my screen server first. I was announced with, well, we don't fix PCBs and such things. In principle, 90% is repairing home electronics, quite harmless. Where did I find a household appliance and etc. So, turn off the screen server first. I hope it will not just turn off now. So, repair initiatives, micro scene, repair cafes, hacker scenes, etc. How can we work together better?
Ich würde sagen, ich fange an.
As I begin with some words about what I am and what I do. Small introduction. What is the repair scene? How has it grown? How does it work at our repair space? What's the advantages? Who from Chaos is already a member? Two examples. And then what all can we do? So, okay, let's begin here. I am Andreas Frisch, alias Fraxinas, alias RepairFox. That depends on where I'm active. I'm an electronic engineer. I do software engineering at the Starbat in Cologne, cloud, video, etc. I founded the Repair Café in 2014 in Aschaffenburg. I gave repair tips in the ARD, as the first German television. And I'm a member of Aschaffenburg e.V. And somebody once said this sentence: somewhere everyone is a hacker, everyone has his own tricks and tips. That was this person.
Jeder Hacker. Jeder hat so seine Tricks im Alltag mit der Technik umzugehen.
He said what we just said. There are a thousand of small things each day, each year, where you need to make yourself comfortable when doing something with technical stuff. He said that very well. For me, hacking is not just hacking on the keyboard and writing software. It's to get through your everyday's life. What can I do with textiles? How can I hack them? How can I repair them? How can I use them otherwise, better, more fantasyful? That's what I find is the soul of the hacking since 1984. And so I think in the Repair Café we should do our contribution to it. The Repair Café movement long time ago, you didn't use that. The smith in your village could repair everything from the horse stuff until the VW cover. But now we are in a society where products are made for much shorter lifespans. And in 2009, I think it was an environmental journalist in Holland who founded this well logo and this name of the repair cafe, this concept of the repair cafe as she founded and made this available for a small fee. For a small fee you could use this logo, the repair cafe name and logo, and in Germany and in other European countries they provided a small starter kit, how you can deal with press and oh no, that was the screensaver. And transparency to forms for the templates, etc., where you could quickly start and build up, found your own repair cafes. And in 2011, 12, 13, this really started in Germany. In Germany, this, I call it organization of the repair cafes, they are from a foundation, they were started, and you can find them under this link, repairinitiatives.de, and there you find many repair cafes and similar organizations in the German-speaking region of Europe. They can add their calendar entries, and yeah, there are quite a lot of people which help there. Today it was 699 entries of peoples and hackerspace which contribute, but maybe not everyone is still active, but at least they have registered there, and I think most of them is still active. The network Reparaturinitiativen also supports when founding new repair initiatives. So there is quite a big list with documents, with templates, with people that can help you, with other repair initiatives which could help you and do a patronage and support you in any way. And similarly to our chaos events, in a much smaller scale, they have meetings, assemblies, where you can meet each other, exchange your experiences, etc. There's also a round table repairing. I call it the political part of the repair movement. There we do lobbying for in the politics. There are also environmental thoughts about this. There are scientists part of it, etc. And we want that repair parts can be easily obtainable. It should be obtainable by law. Apple should not. It should be possible for free. People should be able to get repair parts. So in short, if things are not available anymore for simple parts, for instance, we could print different parts, but usually you need a CAD drawing or diagnosis tools for digital devices, which are closed source. And yeah, well, reverse engineers know what I'm talking about, how difficult it is to get the appropriate tools. And from the economy, from the repair economy, they want to reduce the tax for repairs. This would, of course, make the whole thing a lot more attractive for the end user. At the moment, usually it's repairs are not economic.
No, for a very typical procedure in our Aschaffenburg Repair Cafe, we have also started with that logo, but we created our own logo last year. And also that label, together we can do that. And let's start with our board of papers. Most initiatives do it that way, that guests, and I will really stress guests, so it's not customers here, put up like a paper where they write their name and their signature and to agree on the house agreements, and also agree on that if the device gets broken in the repair, that it's okay to them, so it's like a legal security. And also a description of the error message, so what doesn't work exactly. We try to keep that already a good description already at the start, so the person who is caring for them, these papers are numbered on the board, so one of the repair people takes one of them and maybe look what thing they could fix, and they take one of them and call the guest and try to repair together with him. So the idea is we try to help people to help themselves, so we just lead the guest in repairing him on his own device, give them the right tools, give him tips. Most times it is like that the repairing people is doing most part, but often that the guests also want to do something themselves or just want to have a look how to open their thing. And every repair person has his specialties, what he can do best. Not everyone can try to repair tube radios. So there's, right from the beginning, there's different categories like textile work or so on. And we divided by that. And the repair people bring their own tools. So their tools they can work best with. They have like, their own toolbox, like measurement tools or sewing machines, glue, so on. And they divide up onto different tables where the guests are sent to or where they are asked to go there, depending on what device they have. So it's called Repair Cafe most times. So sometimes called differently, like in Leipzig it's called Café Kaputt, so Café Broken. Most times it's something with Café in the name, and that, you might guess that guests get some food and drink there. We have like coffee and cake, and in that photo we have been to some Red Cross, quarter where the people have done Turkish food on basis on donations. Sometimes people bring food themselves, so in exchange for the repair they bring some cake or so on. What you can also do is bicycle repairs that has been outside in front of the repair cafe. The ADFC, the German Bicycle Club, had put a pavilion there, tent there, to do smaller repair work on bicycles. We don't want to concur with the professional people who pay for their living from that, so we don't want to take customers from the bicycle repair shop around the corner, but we send the people there to buy their replacement parts, and if it's like more complicated, they we tell them to do it there as well. The same thing applies to more complicated repairs on like, yeah, audio equipment or some special equipment that we won't be able to fix in a repair cafe. So we don't want to argue with like professional repair shops. Textile work is also one a big part of our work. We have like sewing people who like to teach the people how to sew their trousers themselves and repair their clothing and so on. So something I don't know anything at all about, but it's yeah much appreciated, textile work. Here you can see in our youth center in Aschaffenburg, in one of our youth centers, you can see the different repair stations, repair tables. This is most electronic stuff on multiple tables. In the front of the left, there's clothing. To the right, there's electronic, mechanical stuff, and yeah, it's divided by that. And the repair persons sit right next to the visitors, and you really can't distinguish them from each other. Everyone is repairing together with each other. That's like our principal of Aschaffenburg, and I'm repairing the kitchen machine of his wife. So in the beginning, it's also publicity, PR, important people come around and the newspapers write articles on us, and you can do some PR work on that. And in that photo, it's like a CD player, it's opened, and yeah, it's sometimes luck to find the fault part. If you start to analyze the boards with the logic analyzer, it's most kinds, it's too deep into the detail. You can do it if you want to, if you have fun, but in general, you try to serve five guests with like simple things instead of doing one very difficult work. And the synergies, which is like a nice word. What are the advantages for the repair cafe if they try to work together with the hackerspace or makerspace? Often, repair initiatives are a bit, yeah, for elderly people. That doesn't apply to all, but they are. Most times it's older people who have time, who enjoy helping people fix their things, and yeah, there's like we need young people there, and you kind of notice that. And if you look around here, our age is near to zero. Yeah, every age is here, and there's young people, and it's like you don't have to care about getting new people into the hacker scene. So then there's people who have like skills, engineers and technical people, so you don't have to debate on that anymore. And what's also great in the hacker spaces, there's great equipment, so not only measurement tools, but also new fancy prototyping devices, 3D printers, laser cutters, and so on. So 3D printed replacement parts we have also used in the repair cafes. The problem is to construct them. That's a huge time thing. Laser cutters, CNC cutters, we haven't used that yet. It also depends on the people that have the skills and the knowledge. And yeah, rooms, like many hackerspaces have their own clubs, their own rooms. Many repair cafes and repair initiatives don't have that, including the Aschaffenburger repair cafe. We go around from each place to another, between like church centers and youth centers, and to gather the different masses that gather around there, and to give the visitors the opportunity to reach the repair cafe by feet without having to walk too far with their devices, which is great as well. But the disadvantage is that people have to bring their own stuff, their own tools. We can't store it somewhere. In makerspaces, we can, because that's like a dedicated place for making, for repairing stuff, for trying things out. And many repair cafes and hackerspaces or makerspaces have an open,
an open workshop, which is optimal for us. And it's optimal if a repair cafe can be a guest in the rooms, in such rooms. That's with us in Schaffenburg, this is once a year we try to do this. It's a space problem. We don't have enough space. Otherwise we could do it more often. The advantages for us as makers and hackers, we can do good PR. We can we show our engagement for the society. I had a similar talk with a networking meeting for repair initiatives, and the first thing I needed to do was to help them what is a hacker. So it's this word is usually misunderstood. People have fear from hackers. That's usually the first thing that you need to do. And when you repair their toasters, then they see it much more positive, of course. And of course, we all know our planet is not doing that well. We need to protect the environment, which we do. Doing this, of course, each device which does not go to electronic waste is better. Recycling is not that well. The longer a thing works, the better it is. And we can also find new members in repair cafes. I was first in repair cafes and then in a makerspace or hackerspace. There came some young guys from the just newly established Schaffenburg makerspace. I would have never expected that something like this happened here, because it's really a small town. But yeah, it was very well. They came there, I found them, and we also found a lot of more people using this method. And the next topic, applying repair techniques. We might be masters of engineering, etc., but that doesn't still mean that we know how to open a vacuum cleaner. So it's quite well to learn more practical aspects. Honorable mention, the Sustainable Design Center has published a brochure about repairs. Usual example is of kitchen devices, where you can print repair parts. I had a look in these 699 and compared it to the new. I compared it to the list from the DocuWiki of Airfas, and I found out that only 5 initiatives fall together with hackerspaces. This is bizarrely few. I'm sure there is quite a lot more where the address does not match, but for instance, there is Schaffenburg and the repair cafe at Schaffenburg, because the official address of our repair cafe is the youth center and not the hackerspace. maybe this is the case for even more candidates. For instance, at the Dezentrale, I just spoke with somebody from there. You might have seen it in the newest Datenschleuder, it's a magazine of CCC, and you might have seen that, but they don't have an entry in repair initiative, DE. But I saw that many cities have, where a repair cafe exists, there is no chaos traffic, and vice versa. There are many cities where it's just one or the other, not both. In Austria, we have Otello, and they do up to the smallest town and village cool things like hackerspace and kids hacking, etc. Yesterday, somebody from Gmunden was at me and told a bit about it. It's a really cool network. Two examples. Jena has, like Aschaffenburg, since 2014 a repair cafe. And when they were founded, in the initiative when they were founded, probably via Facebook, multiple people from the hackspace were part of this founder initiative. And so it came that the hacker space basically provided the address and money, and they can also get funding from the public, but they don't repair much because it's probably not big enough. They change the localities as we do. What they usually do is they take an old bus and try to rebuild it, to build a workshop out of it. Also, I have a negative example. Schinken told me that after the second try, they stopped it in the hackspace because people, I say customers, not guests, they thought like, hey, you have to fix my things when I arrive here. And that's, of course, not the goal. Nobody wants to do that. Nobody wants to fix Windows machines, and especially not in the open-minded spaces. One important thing is to communicate in advance that the repair cafe has nothing to do with the normal space operation, but that they are dedicated and that the people need to help repairing their stuff, that it is not repaired for them. And have something ready where you can find where you can send the people if they want you to repair, they fix their windows.
Von dem Flyer bei uns auslegen darf.
That works very well. This also applies for radio and TV and household appliances.
Yeah, do something, join some repair initiative, look up where the nearest places to your home place and on repairing initiatives DE on the URL, you can look for that and maybe bring your tools there already, because you can just join them in most cases and take some toaster or something and try repairing or fixing it. Maybe take a laptop and try to fix their software installation thingies, or maybe cleaning the fans. Or if you are already active in a space, then try to maybe found a repair cafe thingy in your space. Talk about that in your meetings, and it's a great thing with like huge publicity effects. Or maybe even go further and read their foundation pages on repaircafe.org, or maybe on repair2initiative.de. gather as many people as you want, as you can, because alone it isn't as fun. And you can like get founding there. And if you need something is missing, like requirements are everywhere. We need repair cafes everywhere. And yeah, you can really, really make a great movement, start a great movement there. Besides the general fixing stuff, we like to talk about, we like to order a lot of stuff in Asia. So maybe try to use old hardware first and maybe make some new things out of it. You can do like project with children to stress sustainability, and that we can fix things with the soldering iron, and not only maybe do button cell coin cell repairs, which are thrown away afterwards. We can do upcycling, we can repair broken hoverboards and upcycle them to very fast bobby cars, and that's something that, let's beat the maker heart faster. I don't know if they've really been broken, but probably. Okay, and there's been a conference, first time this year in November. It was called Bits and Bäume, Bits and Trees. It's a really cool name. I don't know who made that up. Constanze Kurz has been there, and also some other people from the Kais Computer Club. And they told people about digitalization and with sustainability and how that goes along. And I haven't been there, unfortunately, but maybe we'll have that next year again, and then I'll be there, probably. And then in the Chaos Computer Club, there's the R5. It emerged from the TuWatt workgroup in March, resources and recycling, and we've just met before this talk at the assembly and brainstormed some new ideas what we can do in the Chaos Computer Club to make this repair movement more public and more often. We probably find other maker and hacker spaces and chaos traps and airfares that are offering repair cafes already. And maybe we can like list them and do some networking and make some how-to or some guide how to make your own repair cafe in the chaos surroundings. And there's something in the Doku Wiki who's in there, and a channel on Rocket Chat. There's an arm missing. I'll add that. So join the work. Are there any questions?
Ja, erstmal herzlichen Dank.
Okay, thank you. We have quite a lot of time for Q&A. Are there questions? Stand up, go to the microphones. Ah, microphone number eyes. You said that repairing something for people, but it's better to help people repair their own things. And the consequence is that people should do it by themselves. We should support them by looking for data sheets, etc. But people need to repair it. How do others do this? What the advantages and disadvantages?
So in general, the concept is, in most cases, just as you said, help people to help themselves. But in practice, there is thing will get so slow that we can't really do our pile of work in the right time. We have sometimes up to 80 sheets on our board, 80 things willing to get fixed, and we try to process them as fast as possible. In general, it yeah, comes down to that the repairing person does the most part of the work, but the guest is present and is watching the repair. And sometimes you have like elderly people who have no understanding of technical stuff and just enjoy the societal and maybe cake and coffee and so on.
Entschuldigung, geh mal bitte zum Mikrofon, wenn du eine Frage hast. Damit ich kann auch was
please go to the microphones if you have questions.
How many appointments are there? How many meetings? It differs. There's repair cafes that do it every week. But there have also been some places that are connected to some like home, jobless cafes that do it like every day, and then there are some who are doing that only once and then never again, and we are trying to do it 7 times a year, 9 times a year, so about every 6 week.
Microphone number one, bitte, please close to the microphone. I'm interested if how you proceed when you have to repair something. For instance, with my things, I'm quite experimental, and in case it breaks, I don't care that much. And yeah, you have legally well done, but it makes no fun if half of the things break. How do you do this?
You just mentioned like about half of the things go well, and the other half is not repairable and just like broken to no repair. Sometimes it's even more, up to 70%. Sometimes people come with things that are so broken that they just want to get assured you can really throw it away without having a bad feeling about it. Yeah, but besides that, repair is often connected to trying things out, experimenting stuff, and if you want to if you have so many different things on your table you have never seen before, like electrical massage seats and so on, you can just try out. You don't know anything about that. Besides that, at the beginning you said, I'll start by watching a YouTube video. Maybe someone tried to fix that thing before. We do that as well. Often only because just to see how to open the thing, where are the screws, where are the clips.
Okay, ich sehe keine weiteren Fragen.
Thank you, I don't see more questions. There is still a question.
Mikrofon Nummer 2, bitte, klar.
Ich glaube, die waren zuerst.
Ja, wir nehmen Mikrofon 2.
We take microphone 2 now. Thank you. My question, I'm also thinking about starting such a thing, microspace, when you do something for the public. How about liability if you break something? Oh, that's my MacBook Pro, now it's broken.
So most try to get legal assurance against those like liability by the small print on the back of the sign-up formula. So in our case, we write that we aren't liable for things that get broken during repair. It's different if we make like if we hurt people by bad repairs. I haven't heard of a case where that happened, where a person got hurt because of a bad repair, but what exists is by the Anstiftung, there's insurance that assures for about 150 euros per year the repair cafes, that every repair person has an insurance against so like people getting hurt or so on because of bad repairs. You should try to do it as careful as possible. Many repair cafes also do an official VDE like insurance, so the German electronic like community. Some don't because they say we're not a public repair space. We don't have to do that. Yeah.
Was macht ihr mit
What do you do with the things that which are broken beyond repair? Do you send the people back? Do you give it back to them and them should proceed how they want? Or do you recycle it? Do you discard it yourself?
Yeah, both. It differs. People have to sign that they have to take care for their broken things if they are broken. But sometimes we do things like, here's like a repairable device without a broken part, and there's another thing where this part is working, and we can join those things and make one working device out of both. What we also had was an experiment last year in June. We called it like Garbage Festival, where people just could put their things in front of the youth center. So like electronical devices, broken furniture, and other people could pick something out of that waste and repair it in the repair cafe and take it home afterwards. And the other and everything else was trashed by the local garbage collection. And we're going to do this year again.
Applause in the hall. Are there more questions? Microphone number one. A follow-up for the first question. It was about are people doing it themselves or do you help them? I also have sometimes to do with repair cafes, and the question is, what's the goal? Do we want to reuse the device or do we want to teach the people? What is more important? Or how important is the question to you?
Yeah, for us it's like it's an event. We have guests that come regularly, and they try to pick things from the attic just to have a reason to come to us and to enjoy the whole thing. But repair competence and the ability to fix things is what we want to teach the people. It's an important point, of course. Nice that you mentioned that.
Okay, I think that's a nice ending word. Thank you. And you've been listening to